The body of President Pierre Nkurunziza arrived before a solemn crowd in the capital, Gitega. Thousands of Burundians, dignitaries and diplomats paid their final respects. It's a difficult period for the ceremony, given the risks of the pandemic. The government has been criticized for not putting enough measures to stop the spread of the disease. Even here, social distancing was not observed. Few people had masks, and there were only a few hand-washing points at the gates of the stadium. The cause of his death has been equally controversial. The government said Nkurunziza died of a cardiac arrest. But many Burundians, including medical workers, say the cause could have been COVID-19. But that hasn't been confirmed. Despite the controversies, those who paid tribute said he was a unifying leader and was among those who brought peace to Burundi by signing a deal in 2005 that saw the end of a civil war.
When you finished your journey on Earth, you left us in pain, with death in our souls and sorrow.
But many Burundians and human rights campaigners say they will remember him as an autocratic president who led an oppressive government. Things got worse when he decided to run for a third term in 2015, which his opponents said was against the constitution. The political fallout led to violence. Hundreds of people were killed, many more fled from the country, and the economy didn't recover.
And over the last 5 years, he cracked down on the opposition. He made sure that international and local media had it very difficult to operate in country, and he closed both the political space and the country of any influence from outside.
Augustine Twagirizizu was at the stadium at dawn to pay his respects. He survived the civil war of the 1990s and celebrated when Nkurunziza and other armed groups signed a peace deal to end it.
He taught us to farm and united rival Tutsi and Hutu ethnic communities. He taught us to build community projects with our own hands. He built stadiums and hospitals.
The late president was laid to rest on the grounds that had been set aside for a monument of victims of the civil war. Some mourners who came to bury him say they will remember him for the good he did. But many others say he leaves behind a tainted legacy. Katia, Lopez-Hodoyan, Al Jazeera.